So Merry Christmas, Evan. And it's because of you that we, all of us, were just honored with the Time Magazine Person of the Year. See, in the old days, it was called the Man of the Year, right? Would you rather see Person of the Year? Man of the Year. These guys are so politically correct.
All right, so let's talk about that and more. Errol Louis is here. He's the political anchor for Spectrum News. David Swordlick joins me. He's the assistant editor for The Washington Post. And Vicki McKenna is here. She's the host of Upfront on WBIA in Wisconsin. Welcome to all of you.
Good morning.
Good morning. So Vicki, you first, because you were at last night's rally. How were Trump's comments received?
Well, they were received very well. Very enthusiastic crowd at the rally last night. Look, he comes off gregarious, light, warm, welcoming. And he came to Wisconsin to say thank you for a job well done to an awful lot of volunteers who put in countless hours. And so, yes, I think it was very much appreciated what he did in Wisconsin last night. But more than that, it was, you know, reminding everyone in that room that we made history in Wisconsin again, because Donald Trump is the first Republican who has been elected from the state of Wisconsin as president since 1984. So we have an awful lot of historical milestones we've managed to collect here since 2010 in our state.
Well, Vicki, also Paul Ryan, a Wisconsin native son, he was booed by the crowd.
He was booed by the crowd, but this is Wisconsin. A little bit complicated. Wisconsin's got one foot in the Tea Party and one foot in the establishment. And Paul Ryan, depending on who you are talking with, is on the wrong side of one of those things. And so Paul Ryan is a complicated figure in Wisconsin. But by and large, Paul Ryan is quite popular in Wisconsin, as evidenced by his overwhelming victory in his last congressional race. But I think Paul Ryan also understands that he has a role to play. And if his role is occasionally to take a shot here or there from people who are upset with the establishment Republican sort of same old routine, I think he's willing to do that. I think he's actually happy to do that.
All right. Another interesting point, Errol. You heard what Donald Trump was saying about saying Merry Christmas, and he doesn't like Person of the Year. It should be Man of the Year. It seems that he has a foot on each side in the culture wars as well, because yesterday at Trump Tower, Trump met with quite an array of people. And it was part of this diversity council, right? It included football legends Jim Brown and Ray Lewis. He met with Kanye West, who tweeted that he wanted to talk to Trump about what he called multicultural issues, including bullying and Chicago violence. Ray Lewis, the football great, the Baltimore Raven, touted Trump's economic plans for inner cities. Listen.
What we believe with the Trump administration is, if we can combine these two powers of coming together, forget black or white. Black or white is irrelevant. The bottom line is job creation, economic development in these urban neighborhoods to change the whole scheme of what our kids see for our next future.
So Errol, is Donald Trump really saying there's room for everyone, and including those who are not offended by saying Merry Christmas? Or
in my opinion, I would say no. I don't know that Donald Trump at age 70 understands how deeply insulting it is to talk with ex-football players and entertainers about things like urban policy, when there are hundreds, if not thousands, of trained, competent professionals who happen to be African American who would love to contribute and love to help make the country great again. He simply doesn't see it, and it goes all the way back to his campaign when he took a reality show star, Omarosa Manigault, and made her the person in charge of his outreach to black communities, which is why far more than 8 out of 10 black voters did not vote for Donald Trump. This is not the way back. Again, it's deeply insulting. I don't know that he cares or even recognizes it, and it goes all the way through his cabinet picks, like taking somebody who has never served in any government, not even at the city council level, who's never done anything with urban development, and take Dr. Ben Carson, who's a very nice man, and put him in charge of a $50 billion budget with 8,000 employees and responsibility for some really, really important issues. Where this all ends up, I'm not sure, but this is not the way for Donald Trump, I think, to do what he said he's going to do, which is get 90% of the black vote when he runs for re-election.
I don't see that happening. David, was it lip service in New York and then sincerity in Wisconsin?
Well, let me echo what Errol just said, right? Instead of meeting with an array of people who would provide a different view on what communities of color are looking for, instead of meeting with DeRay Mckesson, instead of meeting with the Congressional Black Caucus, instead of meeting with Cornell Brooks from the NAACP, Trump's outreach to washed-up ball players and entertainers is really not the way to go if he really wants to build a bridge to African Americans and people of color. That doesn't mean he can't change this. He's still in his transition. He hasn't even taken office yet, so maybe he'll move toward that as he goes on, but I don't see that as a good start. And I would just like to go on record as saying that the war on Christmas, the Bill O'Reilly war on Christmas, has always been a phony issue, and it continues to be a phony issue.
Vicki, I'm dying to get your reaction.
Yeah, I mean, honestly, we have a zip code in the city of Milwaukee, 53206, and it has been struggling with all of the diverse attention from all of the layers of the various people who claim that the only thing that matters is the color of somebody's skin in a cabinet position, that has left that zip code in the city of Milwaukee dying on the vine. And with all due respect, DeRay Mckesson has never come into the city of Milwaukee and said anything about a wiped out neighborhood, about urban poverty that has been going on for the last 20 years, that has been sucking the lifeblood out of the city of Milwaukee, has said nothing about a lack of economic development. And with all due respect, what do cabinet positions have to do with solving the urban problems in cities like Milwaukee, Wisconsin, or Racine, Wisconsin? They have absolutely nothing to do with it. And quite frankly, with the Black Lives Matter movement, all they have done in the city of Milwaukee is come and stirred things up, said don't trust the police, allowed crime to explode, allowed the murder rate to explode, and essentially condemned the city of Milwaukee to machine politicians keeping people miserable and fearful for their lives.
Can I respond to that briefly?
Errol's dying too, so
Vicki,
Errol first.
Vicki, you must know that year after year, Milwaukee comes up as the most racially segregated city in the country. You probably should know, if you don't know, that the Department of Housing and Urban Development has very serious responsibility for dealing with patterns of housing segregation.
Vicki, please let Errol talk.
In this case, we have an administration that has tried to do something about it. We have an incoming secretary that maybe you have a lot of confidence in, but if you think a retired neurosurgeon is going to address the longstanding racial segregation of Milwaukee, well, good luck to you. I happen to disagree.
With regard to DeRay Mckesson, I just want to clarify, Vicki, one thing is that on a host of issues, I don't agree with Mckesson, but it's undeniable that he has his finger on the pulse of what many younger people of color are thinking and feeling right now. Wait, second point is that I happen to agree with Vicki that diversity in the cabinet is not as important as what those cabinet members do. The Trump administration has signaled that they want to get rid of the Affordable Care Act. That's something that is favored by 75% of African Americans. They've signaled that they want to roll back some of President Obama's initiatives on the Dreamers. The majority of voters of color favor allowing the Dreamers to stay in this country legally. So those are the things that I would agree with are more important than whether white men or someone else are in those top cabinet positions.
And Vicki, couldn't you argue, Vicki, that Donald Trump is meeting with diverse people who probably won't push back too hard against him?
Let me just first say something about, since everybody seems to be claiming to know anything about what's going on in my state, I happen to live in this state. I happen to know what is going on in this state.
Literally, no one claimed to know what was going on in Wisconsin.
Nothing to say about what is going on in the city of Milwaukee or the city of Racine or some of the other urban neighborhoods throughout the cities in the state of Wisconsin. I'll tell you who does, though, and who does get it, and who is routinely dismissed for his ideas on what to do to solve the problem of the decay of the family, of the decline of schools, and that is Sheriff David Clark, who I might point out kicked off last night's rally in the state of Wisconsin, received the most enthusiastic cheers and embrace, and in fact could easily have been running himself in statewide positions in our state, or even as you know, number two on the ticket with Donald Trump. He is a black man. He is a conservative black man. He consistently gets elected in blue Milwaukee. He consistently gets embraced by white people, black people, Hispanic people, Jewish people, gay people, women and men. And so, you know, if you want to actually talk about real diversity, then start talking about real diversity. solutions for problems that have been growing for the last 50 years in this country and are acute and damaging and painful.